Okay, so welcome to lesson 12.3. We're looking at the human kidney. And where it relates in the specification is in 4.5.3.3. And what we're looking at is to be able to describe the function of the kidney in maintaining the water balance of the body and how the kidneys actually produce urine by filtration of the blood and ultrafiltration and selective reabsorption. The parts of the urinary system, so the ureters, the urethra, the bladder, and the structure of the nephron are not needed. We might refer to them to learn about it, but you don't need to remember these terms. Okay, so to look at ultrafiltration and selective reabsorption, it's actually easier to look at the structure of the nephron in a little bit more detail. So what is the nephron? Well, normally when you've seen a kidney, you've seen it done in this kind of shape. If you've ever dissected a kidney, you'll know that you've got an inner medulla and an outer cortex. There's two very distinct regions. Well, the nephron is the basic unit of the kidney, and the way it's organized is like this. So we've got lots and lots of these on the outskirts, and we've got lots of these loops going down into the inner medulla. When you do A-level, you'll come back to that in a lot more detail. So there's two very big words and terms and processes that we need to know: ultrafiltration and selective reabsorption. Let's consider the first one, ultrafiltration. As the blood capillary goes into the kidney, it goes into this massive knot. And you'll notice that the capillary going in is wider than the capillary coming out. So what that does is it creates a really high pressure in there. There's little gaps in here, and that's all you need to know them as, little gaps. And that high pressure forces the components of blood out that will fit through the gap. And that process is called ultra, meaning everything, and filtration. Now, the filtration gives us an idea, a little clue about it. It's on the basis of size. So let's have a little think what's in blood. We've got red blood cells, which we know. They are too large. They won't pass out into this. This is called the Bowman's capsule. Again, you don't need to know the word, but they're too large to pass out into the filtrate. We've got plasma proteins. What do I mean by that? I mean hormones and enzymes. Again, they're too large. They're not going to pass out by ultrafiltration. However, other things like glucose, like mineral ions, salts, and urea, obviously we want to get rid of urea, they will pass out, and they form, as well as water, sorry, that's another big one, they form the filtrate. Okay, so the blood vessel, the capillary that's gone into our ball, our glomerulus, and comes out the other side, has now got a lot less glucose. It's now got a lot less water, it's got less urea, but it's still got the plasma proteins. But as we mentioned, that glucose has been lost, and it doesn't make sense from a survival situation to hunt and gather food, to eat it, to digest it, and then to pee it out, basically. What we want to do is be able to use that for aerobic respiration, so we need to get it back. As the filtrate passes along this tube here, again, it doesn't matter what it's called. It's the whole idea that this blood vessel wraps itself around the tubule. Now, what's going to happen is this. In the walls of this tubule are cells that are loaded with mitochondria. They've got a lot of mitochondria, so there's a lot of aerobic respiration to fuel active transport. Because initially, some glucose is going to move by diffusion, but when it gets to 50-50, when it gets to equilibrium, we need to move those last bits over using active transport. So the mitochondria provides the site for respiration to make ATP to cause that to happen. So we reabsorb all of our glucose. The same is true in controlling our water balance. To control our water balance, we move mineral ions. Because, of course, we know that when you have more mineral ions, water is going to follow by osmosis, and that's going to keep you hydrated, that's going to keep your blood vessels all enlarged and full of the right concentration of blood, if you like. The unfortunate thing that happens is that we do get some reabsorption of urea. We actually want to get rid of it, but just by diffusion, we're going to reabsorb 50% of it back. We're going to get rid of some, and then next time the blood comes back through this system, we're going to lose a little bit more urea, and so on, and so on, and so on. Let's have a look at some questions to check our understanding. So, we've got the first one. Ultrafiltration is caused by, what did we say? Number two, ultrafiltration causes filtration of the blood on the basis of what? What is the defining feature that decides what passes out and what stays in? Name the substances that are found in the filtrate. How are glucose and mineral ions selectively reabsorbed? Why is urea reabsorbed? And why would there be a large number of mitochondria in the cells, the epithelial cells of this tubule? Join us in part two to find the answers.